Abortion has never, not once, killed a single child.
Really? Because it looks like just since 1980, it's killed at least 40 million. Every abortion, every single one, ends in the death of a human offspring.
How to get canceled in under 10 seconds? Let's go. We're going to use the one word strat for today. Female. All right, typing. All right, 20%. Refresh.
If his preference is a petite, innocent, hairless, smooth-skinned virgin, he really wants a child. First of all, I don't know a single guy that has all of those preferences in one. Second of all, those preferences are completely valid as long as the girl is age-appropriate and willing to be with the guy.
No! It's pedophilia! It's pedophilia!
Wow, okay, so what are your preferences then? He has to be taller than me, older than me, more assertive than me, and willing to provide for me. Wow, sounds like what you really want is to be a child.
You son of a bitch!
Hi guys, just a daily reminder that I ain't never seen a man that I fucking need, bitch. You're all replaceable, don't ever get too comfortable, and don't ever think otherwise. You're a guest in this household, and you can be kicked out just as quickly as you were welcomed in. Thank you.
This is what I have to say to you.
You a bitch. You know why you a bitch? Cause I said so. You just a bitchy bitch. You a bitch McBitcherson. You a bitch McBitch. I go to McDonald's and get a McBitch because you a bitch. Bitch.
World, I opened my eyes to the truth about being a girl. I heard guys say things like, dude, she was 10 times tighter than that girl you hit and quit, Ray. Or, I want to pipe your sister someday. Or, her ass looks like a racetrack with those stretch marks, but at least it's big like Kim K's. I never grew up thinking of those things. Don't blame me, but when I thought about boys, I thought about dinner dates and soulmates, not fuckboys that look at you like shark bait. It breaks my heart for every girl growing up in this world instead of how was your day messages.
If straight men don't watch gay porn, you're homophobic.
What?
Girls should be able to walk around shirtless.
She. You got my full support on that.
Wow. It's the pervertedness for me.
Wow.
I'm a female. I shouldn't have to work.
Okay, then you stay home and wash the kids and cook and clean and stuff.
I'm an independent woman. I have things to do.
Wow.
I should be able to suck off the football team without being called
a
slut.
You're a hoe. Just say that.
What's something that's actually incredibly fucking misogynistic, but everyone just ignores it and pretends it's fine?
Marriage. I'll explain. The idea that on a hen night, you go out with your girlies to celebrate. But on a bachelor's night, you go out with strippers, you know, traditionally, because it's your last night single. Being walked down the aisle and given away by your father, taking your man's surname so that you're now his, like, property. The fact that in the traditional wedding vows, the man has to love and honour, and the woman has to love, honour, and obey. Throwing the bouquet to a group of girls to see who gets married next, but there's no equivalent for men. The whole traditional history of a dowry is that the bride's family were paying to get rid of her. The white dress signifying virginity. And there are smaller details that you might not even think about, like the woman has to walk towards the man on the aisle, and the man stands on the right, i.e. the right-hand side of God. Also, when men ask for the father's blessing to propose, that feels... Ugh.
I want to explain why the U.S. Women's National Team sued U.S. Soccer for sexist wage discrimination. Now, there are two reasons. One, they are the most dominant force in women's soccer history. Two, they're idiots. I'm not here to bash women. Hope Solo has done that enough. I just want to clarify what's going on. The U.S. men's team, if you can even call them men, has an incentive-based contract. They only get paid when they play. And by play, I mean get their shit pushed in by the third world. The U.S. women's team was offered a similar incentive-based contract. They turned it down. The women demanded guaranteed money instead. Then they went out and pillaged more foreign women than the Vikings and won another World Cup. So they did the math and realized they would have made more money if they had taken the original incentive-based contract. So they sued to change their contract and receive back pay for all the games they've already played. Obviously, the judge thought this was ridiculous and threw the case out immediately. You can't sue someone for giving you the contract you asked for.
Since 2017, the two biological male runners who have competed in girls' high school track in Connecticut have won 15 women's track championship titles. Titles that were held by 9 different girls in 2016. 4 of those state championship titles should have been mine. They've also shattered girls' track records. Those two biological males now hold 17 all-time individual women's meet records in Connecticut. I remember the 55-meter indoor track competition in the 2019 state championship. I finished in 7.23 seconds. That was the top time among biological girls. but third overall. The male who finished second in the race clocked in at 7.01 seconds. The new women's state champion, also a male, broke the all-time record for the event, finishing in 6.95 seconds, a time that would have earned that same runner 140th place in the men's 55-meter dash that year.
This is a very dirty trick to figure out whether somebody likes you, and I mean, you should know about it. Maybe you shouldn't use it, because it's also known as the cry test. If they are, in fact, into you, and you start crying, they will do anything, anything at all, to stop those tears running down your face. Because they will feel sympathy. However, if they resist and feel annoyed, they hate you.
So, fellas, it's your lucky day, because I am looking for a boyfriend. And with that being said, I have one little requirement. Just one little guy. Just one little thing. You gotta be rich. You gotta have a shit ton of fucking money.
It's a woman's world, so to speak. Pussy, you sour. Never giving credit where it's due, because you don't like pussy in power. Venom. Venom.
Can you see into my eyes like open?
Abortion has never, not once, killed a single child.
I'm not dreaming. This is literally the world we live in.
If you are a public figure and there is an issue going on anywhere in the world and you don't speak out on it, that means that you approve of it and we all have to be against you. If you wear skinny jeans, wear your hair to the side, or use specific emojis, that is really uncool and we will comment in your posts about it. If you do anything that insinuates that you are attracted to the same sex and you're not attracted to the same sex, that is queer baiting and you should not be doing that. Example, Katy Perry, I Kissed a Girl. If you draw fake freckles on your face, that is completely wrong. And you are not allowed to do that, because some people used to get bullied for having freckles on their face, and that is so insensitive of you to enjoy having freckles on your face. If you wear beanies and jackets, that is a bi people thing to do, and that's called bi baiting, and that means you're not appreciating them, and you should not be doing that. If you are able to have babies naturally because you are in a heterosexual relationship and it is easy for you, we will use breeder as a term to put you down.
Spend another minute living among these animals.
We need to talk about something.
What is it?
I don't think this is gonna work out. So you're gonna leave?
You just said this wasn't gonna work out.
I want it to work out.
Why won't this work out too?
You could at least fight for me. You just fucking hit me?
You just told me to fight for you.
Not literally.
I'm sorry.
Get the fuck out. Get out. So you gonna get out?
You told me to get out.
Not literally. See, I knew you wasn't shit.
Can I get a hold?
Get the fuck off of me. So you gonna leave?
You just told me to get out. What do you want me to do? I can't do anything. You want to stay out? What?
She says a lot. What does it say to you? You got all these dudes sitting there and a woman standing in the subway. This is so sad. Men are starting to take this gender equality thing serious. Big up to these men. Let's go. Gender equality. Don't give your seat to women. Ha! You think women deserve your seat? No. Women are equal to men and they deserve to stand.
No, it's fucking... Look at this. Look at this. It's fucking everything. It's everything, right? What's this? This Pride fucking sponsored Costa coffee. Who does this help? Who does it? I'd like a skinny latte, please, with one pump of sugar-free hazelnut syrup. Would you like it in a cup that publicly displays that you're happy with the notion of same-sex couples having the right to... I just want a fucking coffee, mate. It's 6:30 a.m. and in 20 minutes I'm scheduled to interview Amber fucking Rudd. I just need the fucking caffeine. Give me my fucking skinny latte. We don't call it a skinny latte anymore, sir, because that phrase is considered fat-shaming. So I would just fuck off then.
On average, you're getting paid 9% less than a man. That's not fair, is it?
It depends on why it's happening. I can give you an example. Okay, there's a personality trait known as agreeableness. Agreeable people are compassionate and polite. And agreeable people get paid less than less agreeable people for the same job. women are more agreeable than men.
Again, a vast generalization. Some women are not more agreeable than men.
Yes, that's true, but that's right. And some women get paid more than men.
So you're saying that by and large, women are too agreeable to get the pay rises they deserve?
No, I'm saying that that's one component of a multivariate equation that predicts salary. It accounts for maybe 5% of the variance, something like that.
So surely the answer...
We need about another 18 factors, one of which is gender. And there is prejudice, there's no doubt about that. But it accounts for a much smaller proportion of the variance in the pay gap than the radical feminists claim.
What? I'm shy. Oh my God.
Lawyer's reaction.
There's a legal concept called defense of others, which has the same elements of self-defense. Because this woman threw a rock at an elderly person, it gave the man justification when he tackled her to stop her, making him not guilty.
This mother is gonna play the ignoring game tonight. I'm going to play the whoring game tonight. Who's gonna win?
Is marriage to a man who earns less than you worth it? No, okay? Your quality of life is going to decrease. The status that you get from being married to a man who can't work harder than you is not going to be worth it.
What's your type?
I got abs, nice skin, tall.
Okay, what about you?
Man, I like me something real slim, you know what I'm saying? I like me something, big bone, you know, real slim.
Oh, that's body shaming.
Tell me how you just said the same thing I did. So how's that body shaming?
Respectfully.
Because guys don't have feelings. Like, it's f***ing fuck guys. We body shaming all these girls. You gotta look nice for your girl.
All right, but you know what? Double standards. Jada Pickett. That's all I'm gonna say.
Respectfully. Champagne.
What's good? I'm back, and I have some really low-key toxic advice for you guys today. But I think it'll actually help some people, so hear me out. This is for women dating or seeing, exclusive with, whatever, toxic men, okay? You are seeing other girls on his phone, whatever it is, like he's being shady, red flags are popping up. You can do it the healthy way. You can talk things out and probably try to get rid of him, but let's be honest, girls never actually do that. So here's your second option instead of continuing to get manipulated. Three words, one little motto, cheat just in case. Wow, that sounds so bad. Hear me out really fast. Let's think about this in perspective, okay? In about a couple months, you're gonna realize, yep, he was in fact cheating on me the whole time. And you know what? You don't have to feel bad about it because you cheated just in case, okay? You went on that date, you let that man fly you out, you did whatever it was that you wanted to do, you were not manipulated. And you can take that to the grave with you, baby. I love you.
Y'all, tell me why my man who ain't my man, but I say, or at least I act like is my man, but is definitely not my man because he fucking ain't worthy. He has the audacity to text me at 9 p.m. Are you coming? Sir, we have not been on good terms this whole fucking week. Today, we barely even messaged each other and I kept my responses short as fuck. I work tomorrow in the morning and it's foggy as fuck. What the hell do you think? Yes, I fucking drove, guys. I drove to his house and I'm actually right here waiting for him to get in my fucking car because your girl is stupid. I did not learn my lesson in 2020. Oh, lordy.
Okay, there are 8 million people in this city. Sounds like a lot, right? Half of them are women. So 4 million men. And then you gotta have some age limits. Let's say over 20.
Keep it legal.
Under 40.
Keep it sexy.
Now it's a million.
Right. We're talking about a million guys.
But half of them are married. 10% are gay. I want someone college educated, not too ugly, so.
There's your boyfriend.
I wish. He's gotta be taller than me, and he's gotta want kids.
Fellas, even when they hit the wall, guess what? They still have these crazy standards for men. They more than likely had a bunch of good men in the past that they screwed over. So guess what? Apparently there's few and lackluster of good men out there. When they hit the wall, when they actually see their chances of finding a mate that meets their standards decrease, it's everyone's fault. Why the hell do older women post their body count on TikTok? That's more than likely the reason why you're single. Nobody cares about how many bodies you have. It's annoying to see so many women constantly boast their body count. That's something that men don't even do anymore. We don't do that anymore. So why is it constantly older women and just women in general bragging about their body count? It's annoying and it's completely unattractive, which is probably why you're single at that age. Let's be real.
Okay, if you date men, do you have any red flags you look for in them, and what are they?
1, if he refers to women as females exclusively. 2, if he says he's not a feminist. 3, if he says he wouldn't date anyone darker than him. 4, if he believes in or cares about the concept of a body count. 5, if he mansplains everything. 6, if he freaks out at the mere sight of anything remotely non-hetero, seeing a gay couple holding hands, gay scene in a movie, anything like that. 7, if I ask him if he wants to get his nails painted and he responds, ew, no, that's gay. 8, if he says no homo before saying something he perceives as homo. 9, if I say that I do not want to do something or have a certain conversation and he forces the issue, that means he doesn't understand that no means no. Red flag. 11, if he doesn't know the difference between there, and there. If he doesn't know the difference between your and your. If he doesn't know the difference between much and many. 12, if he doesn't respect people's pronouns.
Well, my biggest red flag is if her hair is 90% synthetic and she has a literal Cinnabon at the top of her head. Big red flag, boys. Run away.